أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ قال ربك للملائكة إني جاعل في الأرض خليفة قالوا أتجعل فيها من يفسد فيها ويسفك الدماء ونحن نسبح بحمدك ونقدس لك قال إني أعلم ما لا تعلمون صدق الله العظيم. I just recited a verse from Surah Baqraa. It is verse number 30. And from verse number 30 onwards till verse number 37, Allah is talking about the story of Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. The passage talks about Allah's relationship with His first messenger, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. Allah appointed Hazrat Adam alayhi salam on earth as His Khalifa. The word Khalifa is important over here. That Allah wanted to appoint His vicegerent and His representative on earth. And that's why Allah created Adam alayhi salam and his descendant as his representative on earth. And the meaning of being the representative of Allah on earth is that we are responsible to implement the law of Allah on ourselves, and we have to struggle to implement the word of Allah in the entire world. And Allah is going to ask us on the judgment day that I sent you down on earth as my Khalifa. So what efforts you made for the implementation of my word on earth, and we are answerable about it. The passage mentions that there was a time when there were only angels and jinnat, and then Allah decided to create Adam alayhi salam for this purpose. So but when Allah was going to create Adam alayhi salam, the angels had an objection on it, and they were curious about to know that what is the purpose behind creation of Adam alayhi salam. And they thought that Allah is going to create Adam alayhi salam for his worship. So they said that, O Allah, we worship you all the time, and there are countless angels. They remain busy in the worship of Allah day and night, and they don't get tired. So what is the need of creating another creation? So Allah said, Inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun, I know what you do not know. So the purpose of the creation of Adam alayhi salam was not only to worship Allah, but obviously to play the role of Allah's vicegerent on earth. But this responsibility is too huge. To become the representative of Allah on earth is a huge responsibility, and we cannot practice and we cannot implement and carry out this responsibility without being knowledgeable. That's why Allah gave a lot of potential to Adam alayhi salam for knowledge. The potential of knowledge which is given to humankind is not there in jinnat and in angels. And Allah wanted to show this ability of Adam alayhi salam to the angels. That's why the passage mentions that وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا. Allah taught the names of all the things to Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. And then Allah asked the angels the names of the things, but they said, سُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا. We know only what you taught us. Angels are given a limited amount of knowledge. They know only what they are made for. They only know about their function. So they were unable to give the answers, but Hazrat Adam alayhi salam gave all the answers correct. So on that, Allah said that, look, I told you that I know what you do not know. This creation is much different from you. So when Allah proved that Adam alayhi salam had knowledge, more knowledge than other creation, so Allah asked other creations to give respect to Adam alayhi salam, and the respect will be given to Adam through sajda. So Allah ordered all jinnat and angels to do sajda to Adam alayhi salam in respect. This was not for ibadah, for worship, but this was for respect. In the previous nations, sajda was allowed in respect, as we know that in the story of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam, his story started that he dreamt that a sun and a moon and 11 stars were doing sajda to him. And in the end of the story, his father, mother and the 11 brothers did sajda to him. So in the previous nations, sajda for respect was allowed. So Allah ordered all the angels and jinnah to do sajda to Adam alayhi salam. So everyone fell in sajda except for a jinn. His name was Azazil, and he is commonly known as Iblis and Shaitan now. He refused to do sajda because he was very honorable and he was a very respected jinn at that time. So he thought that now someone else is going to be given higher place and more respectable place than him. So the pride inside him came up and he refused to do sajda. to Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, and he started arguments with Allah that why should I do sajda? I'm made up of fire, he's made up of dust, and fire is better than dust. So because of this disobedience, how can he do the argument with Allah? Allah is the creator of all creations. He knew that he was made up of fire and Adam was made up of dust. So because of his disobedience and because of his arguments with Allah, Allah threw him away from his mercy, and since then he became rajim, and since then he is in the curse of Allah. So when Shaitan was thrown away from the mercy of Allah, he said to God that because of Adam I am deprived of my position, give me time, I will misguide him and I will misguide his children, and you will not find most of them your obedient. So from there Allah gave time to Shaitan that he will have time till Qiyamah, he can misguide Adam and his descendants. But Allah proudly said that my obedient servant will remain obedient to me, and they will not follow you, and they will not give any importance to your evil ideas. And after that, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was asked by Allah to live in Jannah, and Adam alayhi salam was also given his wife Eve. And Allah didn't give Jannah to him without any trial, but he was put in trial there, and Allah asked Adam alayhi salam to enjoy all luxuries of paradise except for one particular tree. The fruit of that particular tree is haram on you. And now the Shaitan started working on Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, and he started misguiding him. And in Surah Al-A'raf, the things are given with much more detail, where Allah says that وَقَاسَمَهُمَا إِنِّي لَكُمَا لَمِنَ النَّاسِحِينَ, that he used to swear in front of Adam alayhi salam that I am giving you the best advice. If you will eat this particular fruit, so you will become an angel, or you will get life forever, you will live in Jannah forever. And these kind of things he said to Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. And at some weak moment, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam ate the forbidden fruit. And after that, Allah asked Adam alayhi salam to leave Jannah because he violated that condition which was there for him to be in Jannah. Allah sent Adam alayhi salam and his wife Hawa and Shaitan down on earth, and Allah said that you will live on this planet on earth for a certain time period, and then I will call you people back, and then I will check who remain obedient to me on earth, and whoever will remain obedient to me during his stay on earth, I will send him back to Jannah, and whoever will remain the obedient of Shaitan, he will be condemned to Jahannam with him. The Holy Quran says, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكَ وَمِمَّنْ تَبِعَكَ مِنْهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. Allah clearly said that I will fill Jahannam with Shaitan and all of his followers. But when Adam alayhi salam came down, he was feeling ashamed and he was weeping a lot, and he was asking Allah for repentance, and he was doing tawbah. And Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was in the plain of Arafat on the Mount of Mercy, where Allah taught them a dua. And this dua is also mentioned in Surah Al-A'raf. Allah taught them to say, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. So they said this dua and they did tawbah, and Allah forgave them. So this story is mentioned in these verses from 30 to 37 of Surah Baqraa. And there are many things which Muslims can learn today from these ayat. First of all, this passage tells us that Allah sent down the messengers for the guidance of mankind since the beginning of this world. The first person on the planet was also a messenger of Allah. So no one can say that when I was there on earth, I didn't get guidance, I didn't get any messenger. The first person on earth was a messenger of Allah. So Allah made the arrangements for the guidance of mankind. So we should have firm belief in the prophets and we should obey all of their teachings. Besides that, the passage reminds mankind the purpose of their life on earth. Allah didn't send down mankind on earth just to enjoy the luxuries of this world, but they are sent over here with a noble mission, and that is the mission of the propagation of faith and the implementation of the word of Allah. So we have to struggle hard for that, to carry out this command. We are answerable about it. And being the vicegerent of Allah on earth, Muslims do mental jihad. Like, they spread the knowledge and they invite people towards the right path, and they implement the law of Allah in this way, in a knowledgeable way. That's mental jihad. And in some cases they also do the physical jihad. When the evil forces create hurdles, and they don't allow the implementation of the law of Allah, so then we had to do the physical jihad. So the both the jihads, mental jihad and the physical jihad, is done in order to carry out the responsibility of being the Khalifa of Allah on earth. And the passage also reminds us that you cannot carry out this responsibility without being knowledgeable. So first of all, we have to strive for knowledge. We cannot go out and do jihad. We cannot go out and do the tabligh without having the good knowledge and enough amount of knowledge about the Book of Allah, about the Law of Allah. So the first step is that we have to strive to gain more and more knowledge, and then they can carry out this responsibility in a better way. The passage also reminds us that Shaitan is an enemy of Adam alayhi salam and all of his descendants, and he is always after us and he is always there to misguide us. So we should remain alert from all the evil ideas of Shaitan, and fighting against the evil ideas of Shaitan is called spiritual jihad. So somehow in this passage, all the different forms of jihad are discussed. The story of Adam and Shaitan also tells us that pride is a very bad thing. Shaitan had a very high rank in the sight of Allah. He worshipped Allah for many years and he had a lot of knowledge. But only one spiritual disease was there in him, and that was pride. And because of that pride, he lost his rank in the sight of Allah and he was cursed. So we should remember that we are humble servants of Allah. We should never feel proud of our knowledge. We should never become arrogant, but we should remain down to earth. And this is the quality which Allah likes and Allah wants to see in mankind. And feeling proud of oneself is only the quality of Allah. It suits Allah alone and not to His creations. And this story also tells us that if mankind does some mistake, so they are not taken away. The honor of being the Khalifa of Allah is not taken away from them. If they do the repentance, they can maintain their honor. Hazrat Adam alayhi salam did a mistake, but he did tawbah. So Allah maintained his position as his vicegerent, as his Khalifa, and as his messenger. So this happens in our life again and again, that we do mistakes, we do disobedience of Allah. But whenever we realize this thing, we should immediately turn to Allah and seek His forgiveness. Allah loves to forgive. We should have faith in it. Allah mentions in the Quran, إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا, that it is one of the great qualities of Allah that He accepts the tawbah of His people, of His servants. So may Allah give the ability us to carry out the role of Allah's Khalifa on earth. And may Allah also give us the humbleness and simplicity. And may Allah also give us a tawbah also. And may Allah accept our tawbah from all the sins. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.